बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन। आई एम योर साइंस टीचर एंड यू नाउ वी आर ऑन यूनिट नंबर 6, दैट इज अबाउट मैटर। टुडे आवर लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर मूवमेंट ऑफ पार्टिकल्स इन मैटर, पोलन ग्रेन्स इन वार्म वाटर, इट्स मीन वी विल डिस्कस हाउ पोलन ग्रेन्स मूव इन वार्म वाटर, then mixing of particle, okay, when we mix different particles then what happened, and what happened when a drop of ink is added to a water, okay. So today we will learn about all these things, okay. But in our previous video we already discussed about what is matter, properties of matter and three states of matter, okay. Solid, liquid and gases, these are three states of matter. And the arrangement of the particles in solid, liquid and gases, they are different. In case of solids, these are tightly packed with each other and they only vibrate about their position, at their own position, okay. And liquids, there is some space between these particles, they have weak force of attraction, and in case of gases, they are very far apart from each other and they can freely move, okay. So today we will discuss at first movement of particles in matter, okay, how the particles move, okay. So let's start from the movement of particle in matter. Let's start from movement of particles in matter, okay. Particles of matter move about all the time. A Swedish scientist named Robert Brown noticed that pollen grains move gently when placed in water. The zigzag motion of particle is called Brownian motion, okay. So look at the first line, particles of matter move about all the time. You can observe this here in that diagram. The number A, it represents the solid, B represents the liquid, and C represents the gases, okay. So these are solid, liquid and gases. And you can easily see the movement of the particle in case of solid, liquid and gases, okay. So little bit movement is little bit different in all three states, but all they are moving. Like in case of solid, they only vibrate, okay. The solid, they only vibrate. Liquids, in which force of attraction are weak, so they can move but not too much. But in case of gases, there are a lot of space between the particles, so they can freely move all around, okay. So that here ABC, that is the example of the water molecule. It's mean A, they represent the solid, it's mean they represent the movement of the particle in case of ice. B is a water and C is a steam, okay. So in second animation you can easily see the movement of the particles in liquid, okay. If we add some other particle on the surface of the water, they move like this, okay. And in third diagram here you can easily see that represent the Brownian motion, okay. So one Swedish scientist, his name was Robert Brown, he noticed the quick movement of the pollen grain on the surface of the water. It's mean when we place this pollen grain on the surface of the water, they are moving, okay. So they move like zigzag motion, okay. They show a zigzag motion of the particle and that is called as the Brownian motion, okay. Brownian motion name is on the name of the scientist, that is the Robert Brown, okay. The zigzag motion of particle, it is called as the Brownian motion, okay. So invisible moving particle of the water, it's mean if we observe the water, we are not able to see the movement in the water, but actually the particles of the water are moving, okay. And that's why the pollen grain, when we place pollen grain on the surface of the water, they move and they show the zigzag motion of the particles because of the moving particles of the water, okay. So zigzag motion of particle is called as the Brownian motion. Now let's consider one more example of the movement of the particle. Now here we have to consider the example of dust particle, okay. Dust particle are knocked about by moving particles of the air. Okay, so observe a beam of light coming into a dark room through a slits in the curtains. So millions of dust particles will be seen dancing about in the beam of light. Okay, you can see in both animation, you can see these are the movement of the dust particle. Okay, so movement of the dust particle, and we can observe this movement of dust particle in a beam of light. Okay, so when a beam of light coming in dark room through small holes or through slits in the curtain, so we can observe a million of small dust particle dancing about in a beam of light. Now here we will discuss the movement of pollen grain in warm water. Okay, sprinkle some pollen grains on the surface of warm water in a dish. The pollen grain will appear to be dancing on the surface of the water. Okay, the reason is that when the water is warm, it's mean the movement of the particles in liquid become more. Okay, because of more high temperature or because of heat, they have more kinetic energy and they are continuously moving. Okay, so if we sprinkle some pollen grain on the surface of warm water, then the pollen grain, they appear dancing on the surface of the water like this. Now next we have mixing of particles. Okay, so put a drop of red ink in a beaker containing water. The red color of ink will spread evenly in water, making it pink or light red in color. Okay, so look at this picture. If we just add a drop of red ink in a container, they start spreading. Okay, and in this animation you can easily observe this spreading of red color in a container. Okay, so it's mean if we add a drop of ink in a beaker, so the particles of the color, they start spreading in the water, and they, when they evenly spread in water, they change the color of the water. This shows that they are, that is the mixing of the particles of liquid or water and the ink particles. Okay, the particles of ink move about as well as those of the water. It's mean the particle of the ink, they are moving, and particles of the water, they are also moving. The particle of ink fill the space between the water particles. Okay, so it's mean there is a space between the particles of the liquid, and that space is filled by the ink. So water appears pink. Okay, so the mixing of the particle is called as the diffusion. Okay, mixing of particle is called as diffusion. Okay, so you can easily observe that is green in color, so no problem. So we can easily see the mixing of these particle in a liquid. Okay, so mixing of particle, this is also called as diffusion. So diffusion is basically the movement of the molecule from higher concentration towards the lower concentration. Okay, so movement of molecule from higher concentration towards the lower concentration, and because of that there is a mixing of particle. Okay, okay, now here we have to see what happens when a drop of ink is added to a water. Okay, as water molecules move around randomly in a mixture with the ink, they bump into ink molecule, causing them move randomly as well. As a result, on average, the ink molecules move from area with more molecules, mean from higher concentration, to the area with fewer molecules, it's mean towards the lower concentration. Okay, so it's mean when water molecules, they are moving randomly with them, if we mix ink with it, so both molecules, they are moving. Okay, so what happened after that? The ink molecule move from area of more molecule. It's mean if we put one drop of ink in a water, so at that point the concentration of ink molecules are more, so they start moving from higher concentration towards the lower concentration, and as a result there is a mixing of water and ink. Okay, and they change the color of the water. This shows the process of diffusion A movement of the particles occur in a liquid. Okay, let's see the effect of temperature on the movement of the molecules. Okay, how temperature affect the movement of the molecules. So the temperature of a substance is related to how fast the molecules are moving. Okay, so it's mean the temperature, they affect the movement of the molecule. So in hot water, the molecules were moving faster than they were in the cold water. Okay, so it's mean warm water, mean temperature is high, because of that the water is warm. So in warm water, they are moving, the particles of the liquid of water, they are moving faster as compared to the cold water. So this causes the dye in hot water to diffuse or move throughout the water more quickly. Okay, so it's mean the movement of the water molecules are faster or quicker in hot water. So if we add a drop of any dye in a water, so they spread more quickly as compared to the cold water. You can easily observe the difference between the hot water and cold water. You can see in this hot water the color, they can easily disperse or diffuse all around the water, but in cold water this process is slow. Okay, so the reason is that the movement of the molecule is high in case of hot water and low in case of cold water. Okay, similarly in second picture you can also observe, at same time if we add a drop of color in both containers, so what happened in case of cold water? This blue color represents the cold water, this first container in which we add the blue color, that is the cold water. So the process of dispersion is slow, or the process of diffusion is slow, but in case of hot water the process of diffusion is fast. Okay, so it's mean the temperature is related to the movement of the molecule. So if temperature is high, I mean if the water is hot, the movement of molecules are fast, and because of that the process of diffusion occur more quickly as compared to the cold water. Okay, with this video all of you have to read page number 53. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.